Hello students, welcome to ARS Biological Paradise. Today in this video we are going to see a new topic that is called pancreas. Pancreas is most significant gland because it performs two works. It is example for both exocrine and endocrine gland. So that is called we can say heterocrine glands or composite glands. So where the pancreas is located, what is the function, what are the various role? In this chapter we are going to discuss all these things in detail. Listen students, pancreas otherwise called heterocrine glands. Are composite gland. It has both the function. It has exocrine and also endocrine function. It performs both the functions because this pancreas has two types of tissues, two major type of tissues. Before that, where is it located? Actually, location. Below the stomach. Below the stomach. It is a leaf like structure. Leaf like structure below the stomach. This leaf like structure, that is called pancreas, has two major tissues. Out of this, one is called Acini tissues, second one is called islets of Langerhans tissues. So this Acini tissues perform exocrine function. This islets of Langerhans perform endocrine functions. So these two tissues performs various functions, especially acidic tissues performs exocrine function. So there is secreted enzymes which is helpful for digestion, whereas the islets of Langerhans tissues secretes various hormones. What are the hormones? What are the role of these hormones? We will see detail. See here, I'm going to draw a simple diagram. Here, this is esophagus, stomach, here duodenum, here in this region below the stomach a leaf like structure. So like this, a leaf like structure is there. Since this leaf-like structure has a duct, so like this, this is called pancreas. This is called pancreas. So inside the pancreas, you see that some special tissues are there, some cells or tissues. So like this, so inside the pancreas some special tissues are there. These cells are called islets of Langerhans. Islets of Langerhans. So totally the leaf structure is called pancreas. So the black structure is there. So this is called islets of Langerhans. This islets of Langerhans act as endocrine part, whereas the remaining tissues are called acidic tissues. This is called exocrine function. So pancreas plays a double role. It acts as an exocrine gland and also it acts as an endocrine gland. Exocrine part is called acidic tissues. Endocrine part is called iris of Langerhans. So iris of Langerhans, these tissues has three types of cells. So we will see what is iris of Langerhans, what are the various types. Iris of Langerhans. This iris of Langerhans has three types of tissues, three types of cells. One, alpha cells. The second one is beta cells. The third one is delta cells. So alpha cells, beta cells, delta cells. Alpha cells 25%, so beta cells 60%, delta cell only 10%. This alpha cell secretes a hormone that is called glucagon, whereas beta cell secretes a hormone that is called most interesting hormone, that is called insulin. The third, delta cells secretes a hormone that is called somatostatin. So totally there are three types of hormones from iris of Langerhans. Iris of Langerhans has three types of cells: alpha cells, beta cells and delta cells. Alpha cells only 25%, beta cell 60%, delta cells 10%. Whereas alpha cells secretes an important hormone that is called glucagon. Beta cells secretes insulin. The third, delta cells secretes somatostatin. So these three hormones are essential for various functions in the body. Especially these two hormones maintains the glucose content in the blood. These two hormones are antagonistic in actions, whereas this glucagon, this hormone increase the glucose, it increase the glucose level, whereas insulin, it decrease the glucose level. So it is antagonistic in function. How the glucagon increase the glucose level, how the insulin decrease the glucose level, we will see in detail. See, after digestion, the carbohydrate, the macromolecules are break down into micromolecules, that is called glucose. This is called digestion. So what happens for glucose? So see here, glucose. This glucose which is present in the blood, what happens inside the body? This glucose is converted into glycogen. Converted into glycogen. And this excess glucose, actually this is excess glucose, not all the glucose, the excess glucose is converted into glycogen and it was stored in liver and also in adipose tissues. So excess glucose is converted into glycogen and it was stored in liver and also in adipose tissues. This conversion, glucose is converted into glycogen. The glucose, excess glucose is decreased. This conversion is by insulin. So excess glucose converted into glycogen, this decrease condition of glucose by insulin. So insulin decrease the glucose level. Whenever the excess glucose is present in the blood, the excess glucose alone is converted into glucose, this is decreased. So this insulin is called hypoglycemia. ग्लाइसेमिक हार्मोन, इसका नाम हाइपोग्लाइसेमिक हार्मोन, इट डिक्रीज द ग्लूकोज लेवल. वेरस वंस अगेन व्हेन वी नीड, व्हेन देयर इज शॉर्टेज ऑफ ग्लूकोज, वी नीड ग्लूकोज, व्हाट हैपेंस अगेन, दिस ग्लाइकोजन इज कन्वर्टेड इनटू ग्लूकोज अगेन. व्हेन वी नीड मोर ग्लूकोज, इफ द ग्लूकोज लेवल इज वेरी लेस इन ब्लड, व्हाट हैपेंस, दिस ग्लाइकोजन इज अगेन कन्वर्टेड इनटू ग्लूकोज. Now this is increased in blood level. So this glycogen is converted into glucose by glucagon. So whenever the glucose is excess, it has to decrease by insulin. So this is called hypoglycemic hormone. Whenever the glucose is less in blood, immediately what happens? The glycogen is again converted into glucose by glucagon. So this glucagon increase the glucose level in blood. It increase the blood level. So increase the glucose level. So it is called hyperglycemic hormone. Hyperglycemic hormone. So it is hypoglycemic hormone. Why it is called hypoglycemic hormone? It decrease the glucose level. What is called hyperglycemic hormone? It increases the glucose level. So glucagon and insulin is antagonistic in function. So in this chapter, these 4-5 words are there, most important to understand and very easy to understand. So what is glycogenesis? You know, genesis means formation. So formation of glycogen. Formation of glycogen is called glycogenesis. Whereas, what is glycogenolysis? Genolysis. Lysis means destruction. Lysis means destruction. So, destruction of glycogen. The glycogen is breakdown into glucose. The glycogen is breakdown into glucose. So, the breakdown of glucose is called, that is called lysis, glycogenolysis. This is called what? Glycogenolysis. Whereas, what is gluconeogenesis? One word is called neo. So, what is gluconeogenesis? Gluco, which means, you know that glucose. Genesis means formation. What is neo? That is, the glucose formation. From non-carbohydrate, especially from lactic acid and also lactic acid. So glucose formation takes place, but from non-carbohydrate part, from lactic also, lactic acid. So this is called gluconeogenesis. What is hyperglycemia? This term is second more important. What is hyper? Hyper means always high. So, the glucose level is high in blood. So, this condition is called hyperglycemia. Whereas, hypoglycemia, hyper means always, you know that low. So, glucose level is low in blood. So this condition is called hypoglycemia. So already I told that insulin, it decreases the glucose level. So it is called hypoglycemic hormone. Whereas glucagon, it increases the glucose level. So it is called hyperglycemic hormone. So these are the four important terms you have to understand. The formation of glycogen is called glycogenesis. What is glycogenolysis? Destruction of glycogen into glucose. So, glycogen converted to again glucose. It is called glycogenolysis. What is gluconeogenesis? Glucose formation takes place, but from non-carbonated particles and also from lactic acid. It is called what? Gluconeogenesis. Hyperglycemia means the glucose level is high in blood. This condition is called hyperglycemia. Hypoglycemia means the glucose level is low in blood. That is called hypoglycemia. So, the maintenance of glucose That is called homeostasis. Homeostasis. Homeostasis of glucose is maintained by both insulin and glucose, and also by islets of Langerhans. Islets of Langerhans. So in this chapter, we have discussed what is pancreas, both exocrine and endocrine gland. It is otherwise called heterocrine gland. This is a leaf-like structure below the stomach. It has two types of tissues. One is acini, and one is called islets of Langerhans. Acini acts as an exocrine part, which secretes digestive enzymes, whereas islets of Langerhans secretes hormones, which act as an endocrine part. Islets of Langerhans have three types of tissues. Three types of cells are there: alpha cells, beta cells, and delta cells. Alpha cells secretes glucagon, beta cells secretes insulin, delta cells secretes somatostatin. This somatostatin inhibits the secretion of both glucagon and insulin. So whereas this insulin decreases the glucose level, whereas glucagon increases the glucose level. So these two hormones antagonistic in their function. Thank you, students.